camera.
That's all right. I start thinking I'm gonna break the camera.
I'm waiting to meet this girl.
Wait, you take these glasses off.
You can't see either way.
What's all this stuff in there?
It's a hair. I don't know how that got in there. Seriously, look at this. There's a hair inside.
Inside of it. How'd it get in there?
I don't know.
That's longer than your hair, too.
I know it. All of a sudden, I'm looking, I says, it's always that scratched. But look, it ends there and it ends there.
That's strange.
How in the heck did it get inside that camera?
Well, yeah. Yeah, I'm glad you.
Tubers, this is the military funeral I went to, and it is at the Fayetteville Veterans Cemetery today. Sorry I didn't get procession, but anyway, it was for a Korean War vet. And he was 80 years young when he died. This is one of the things that I do a lot of. Patriot Guard, and they're a nice bunch of group guys. I'll have to try and get video of the next funeral, but out of respect for the family, I prefer not to. At the next Patriot Guard Mission, I'll try and get the parade or the funeral procession. And with this next video, so just to let y'all know where I was today. It is a great feeling to know it's a great feeling to know that there are people out there that do care. I think it was once said that there is no greater love than a lady down to one's life for one's country. Started out outside of Fayetteville city limits and didn't even go on 540. So it went on the side road. And as you can see, I've decorated my motorcycle with two American flags for this occasion. This is where I was today, is with the Patriot Guard Riders of Northwest Arkansas. That's where I was today. They usually do a briefing after the procession, but they didn't do that today. So as what they usually do, or they meet somewhere down at a local restaurant. So just to let y'all know, this is Renegade Biker 24. This is Thursday, March, I think 26th, or not May, March, I mean May. I feel a sense of pride in attending these missions because my late uncle was in the Army Air Corps. He was on the B-17 Flying Fortress, and he was in the Flying Fortress and did almost every job in there except for ball turret gunner. Had to be about 5'6" in order to be a ball turret gunner. He did a lot of missions, and it was over Germany, part of the Berlin Raiders. He was on the 8th Air Force, bombing wing. I can't remember the squadron, but he had an alley-oop that was on his plane that he was in. So I call him the Alley-Oop Squadron, and it was named after the cartoon, Alley-Oop, which is, I think, a caveman. And it was a big cartoon back in the day. When my late uncle served in the military, when he got back, he was on the Queen Mary, and from what I understand from my mom, it was like the it was like what she had said, that when he was on the Queen Mary, he felt like he was in heaven because of all the bright lights, and thought he had made his way to heaven after seeing so much hell. I really respect those who serve in the military and have been in the military. It is not an easy thing. Luckily, I never saw my friend die when I was in the service. And I know my late uncle did. And that's something that he didn't really talk about that much. And I can see why. This is an interesting mission to go on, and each mission going on with the Patriot Guard. Because, in my opinion, it is honoring my late uncle and all of those who have served. Me being a United States Navy vet, I sometimes relive some certain memories that I prefer not to recall, but when person joins the military, it is quite an experience. It is very quite of an experience. To experience atmosphere is something that it's hard to explain, really. When I was in, it was mainly like a fraternity. I'm glad I